हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस सेशन ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 11, दैट इज एनहांसमेंट ऑफ फूड प्रोडक्शन, वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न रिगार्डिंग द रोल ऑफ माइक्रोब्स एज बायो फर्टिलाइजर्स. नाउ यू नो दैट फर्टिलाइजर्स आर द सब्सटेंसेस व्हेन एडेड टू द सॉइल इंक्रीज द न्यूट्रिएंट्स इन द सॉइल एंड इंक्रीज द फर्टिलिटी ऑफ the soil. So when fertilizers are added to the crop field, the productivity of the crop increases. Hence fertilizers are used to increase the yield or productivity of the crops. Then the period after 1960 is called as Green Revolution. Now the main aim of Green Revolution was to increase the yield or productivity of the crops by using different types of fertilizers, then insecticides and pesticides. You know that the population is growing day by day. So to fulfill the needs of food requirement for the growing population, the productivity of the crops is necessary to increase. So there is use of different kinds of fertilizers to increase the productivity, and to protect the crops, insecticides and pesticides are used. Now fertilizers are of two main types. The first one is chemical fertilizers. Now chemical fertilizers are artificially or synthetically produced by using the nutrient or mineral nutrients. That is NPK, means nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. So these mineral salts are mixed in proper proportion and are used as chemical fertilizers, and these are prepared in different industries, and they are inorganic in origin, hence they are called as chemical fertilizers. But excess use of chemical fertilizers causes the pollution of soil, water as well as air. Similarly, continuous use of chemical fertilizers increases the acidic nature of the soil and thus decreasing the fertility of soil. So by using biological fertilizers, we can avoid the soil pollution, then water pollution as well as air pollution. Then second type is biological fertilizers. Now biological fertilizers are of organic origin or biological origin. Now the common biological fertilizers are, the first one is FYM. Now FYM means farmyard manure. Now farmyard manure is the mixture of cattle dung, then waste fodder and urine of cattle. So this farmyard manure is produced by decomposing this mixture, that is cattle dung, then urine as well as waste fodder. Then compost. Compost is prepared by laying different layers of vegetable waste, then plant waste, and water is used, and this waste is allowed to decompose, and the material which is produced after decomposition is called as compost. Then comes the green manure. Now green manure means the plants or certain leguminous plants like sun hemp, they are grown in the field, and then these plants are plowed and buried in the soil, and after their decomposition the green manure is produced. So these biological fertilizers, that is farmyard manure, then compost, green manure, increase the nutrient capacity of the soil or increase the fertility of the soil and thus help in increase in the production of different crops. Then the next topic is biofertilizers. Now biofertilizers are nitrogen fixing microorganisms and these are used to increase the nutrient quality of the soil. So use of microorganisms or use of nitrogen fixing microorganism to increase the nutrient quality and soil fertility are called as biofertilizers. Now biofertilizers are commercially prepared by using different forms of bacteria and fungi. Then biofertilizers are used for organic farming. Now you know that at present day we see that different crops, then do different vegetables, then fruits are labeled as organic. Now organic means that all the material used, that is biological pesticides are used, then biological fertilizers are used. So no chemical pesticides or fertilizers are used in organic farming, and due to this the harmful chemical pesticides and insecticides as well as chemical fertilizers can be avoided and their harmful effects can be reduced. Then biofertilizers are cost effective, that means they are cheap or they require low cost for their production. Then they are eco-friendly, that means they do not cause pollution or they do not have harmful effects. Then biofertilizers maintain long-term soil fertility, that means the soil fertility can be maintained for a longer period as the mineral nutrients are increased in the soil due to these biofertilizers. Now we will see the types of biofertilizers. Now the first type of biofertilizer is nitrogen fixing biofertilizers. Now nitrogen fixing biofertilizers include nitrogen fixing microorganisms which convert atmospheric nitrogen into nitrogenous compounds like nitrates and nitrites, and these are used by the plants for their growth. Then these nitrogen fixing biofertilizers are also called as diazotrops, and they are of two types. The first one is symbiotic nitrogen fixing microorganisms. Now symbiotic nitrogen fixing microorganisms are generally associated with the roots of leguminous plant, and inside these roots of leguminous plants these symbiotic nitrogen fixing organisms live and carry the process of nitrogen fixation, and in return they get shelter to live inside the root. Now example of symbiotic nitrogen fixing microorganisms is rhizobium, then anabina, franchia, and these are generally associated with roots of leguminous plants. Then the second type of nitrogen fixing biofertilizer is free living nitrogen fixing microorganisms. Now free living means are not associated with any other organism, hence they are called as free living, and these microorganisms also convert atmospheric nitrogen into nitrogenous compounds like nitrates and nitrite. An example of it is Azotobacter, then Nostoc, Clostridium and Bejirinka. So the first type of biofertilizer is nitrogen fixing biofertilizers. Then the second type of biofertilizer is phosphate solubilizing biofertilizers. Now phosphate solubilizing biofertilizers include some bacterial species which solubilize insoluble inorganic phosphate compounds from rock phosphate, and it is added to the soil, and this phosphate is utilized by the plants for their proper growth and development. Now the bacterial species which are involved in conversion of this inorganic insoluble phosphate into soluble phosphates are Pseudomonas striata, then Aspergillus species, Bacillus polymixa, etc. Then the third type of biofertilizer is compost making biofertilizers. Now compost making biofertilizers involve the microorganisms or microbes which break down organic matter into simple form, or it is called as compost or humus. So the dead remains of plants like leaves, branches are decomposed, or this organic matter is converted into compost, or it is called as humus, by the organisms like bacteria, fungi, protozoa, rotifers and actinobacteria. So these bacteria convert organic matter into compost or humus, and this compost or humus is rich in different kinds of minerals. Then the fourth type of biofertilizer is called as cyanobacteria, and these cyanobacteria are used as biofertilizers. Now cyanobacteria may be aquatic, that means found in water. Some are terrestrial, that means they are found on land. Some are free living, while some form symbiotic association with other organism. Then they are aerobic, that means they require oxygen for the process of respiration. And they are photosynthetic, that means these cyanobacteria show presence of chlorophyll, and with the help of photosynthesis they can produce their own food material. So these nitrogen fixing cyanobacteria can be used as biofertilizers, and examples are Anabina, then Nostoc, Oscillatoria and Plectonema. Here is the diagram of Nostoc, and Nostoc shows a special structure called as heterocyst. Here we can see heterocyst. So these bacteria develop in colonies, and this heterocyst is generally larger in size, and it carries the process of nitrogen fixation, and it is found in cyanobacteria like Nostoc. And this heterocyst convert atmospheric nitrogen into nitrogenous compounds like nitrates and nitrites, and these nitrogenous compounds get added to the soil, and such cyanobacteria can be used as biofertilizer in rice crop. So here we have seen the fourth type of biofertilizer.